The Who's guitarist Pete Townshend never liked Led Zeppelin. In 1995, Pete fumed, "I don't like a single thing they've done. I hate the fact that I'm even ever slightly compared to them." And you can see it on YouTube. There's some Pete Townshend interviews. Pete Townshend expressed his discontent with Led Zeppelin on more than one occasion. He even accused Zeppelin of copying The Who, and this is what Pete claims. "We were copied by so many bands, principally by Led Zeppelin. You know, heavy drums, heavy bass, heavy lead guitar. The Who were okay, but without me, they would have all ended up working in the flower market, or worse, in Led Zeppelin." Whoa, what a pompous, bold statement. And Pete also adds, "I just never ever liked them. It's a real problem to me because as people, I think they're really, really great guys. I just never liked the band. I don't know if I have a problem because they became so much bigger than The Who in so many ways, but I never liked them," he said, rubbing his eyes. Townshend claims the problem with the band has never been a personal one. Actually, Pete Townshend first saw Jimmy Page in action when Pete was still at school and never forgot how Jimmy was amazing. And this is what Pete recalls. "I first saw Jimmy Page when I was 14 or 15, and he was already in a professional band. He was 1 year older than me, and as a professional musician at 16, he was earning £30 a week when I was just still in school. He was playing really fast stuff. He was an extraordinary player, arrogant and flashy." A few years later, Jimmy Page played as a session guitarist on The Who's first hit single, "I Can't Explain," and its flip side, "Bald-Headed Woman." For years, Jimmy Page was a very in-demand session player. Up until the formation of Led Zeppelin, he seemed to live in every London recording studio, appearing on countless sessions. He played acoustic 12-string guitar on two tracks on the King's debut album, "I'm a Lover, Not a Fighter," and "I've Been Driving on Bald Mountain." Also on Joe Cocker's version of the Beatles song, "With a Little Help from My Friends," on the Rolling Stones song, "Heart of Stone," and on Shirley Bassey's Goldfinger, and so many, many others. You can Google it. You can see all the songs Jimmy's played on. So, in November 1964, Pete Townshend and his band gathered in the studio to record "I Can't Explain." Shel Talmy, the producer who'd been working with the Kinks, brought session guitarist Jimmy Page in to record guitar tracks. Page was favored session guitarist of record producer Shel Talmy. As a result, he secured session work on songs for The Who and the Kinks. Of course, for Pete Townshend, being The Who's guitarist and band leader, seeing someone turn up as, you know, a session guitarist to play guitar might have been natural to feel suspicious, even resentful, about the hired hand's presence. I mean, come on. So it was evidently when Townshend started feeling some type of animosity towards Jimmy Page in the early days. And I read an interview, he was actually furious when Jimmy Page showed up at the studio to record Who song. So Pete Townshend was reluctant to allow Page's contribution on the final recording. Jimmy Page later gushed, "I didn't need to be there. I'm playing the riff in the background. You can barely hear me." But Page recalled the magical feeling of being in the control room. He says, "You can't be more privileged than that," he said of the session with The Who. In May 1974 interview with Cream magazine, Jimmy Page recalled playing rhythm guitar on "I Can't Explain" as a session guitarist. This was confirmed by Pete Townshend and producer Shel Talmy. According to those working on the recordings, however, Page's contribution did not make the final cut. He says, "I was on "I Can't Explain" just playing rhythm guitar in the background," he clarified in 2004. "But the main riff," he confirmed, "that's all Pete. He was roaring, man." But however, in Daltrey's 2018 autobiography, Roger Daltrey gives his version of the "I Can't Explain" recording and states that Page was on lead guitar. He says, "He played the lead guitar. He played the solo." That's what Daltrey says of Page. "I think because it was done live, basically, and to do the chops and the solo at the same time, something has to drop out. It just kept the continuality of the song going." Surprisingly enough, according to Daltrey, there weren't any internal issues, despite the forced addition of an outsider. He said, no, it kind of made sense and it sounded great. Besides, Daughtry says the backing vocals weren't theirs either. It was handled by a group called Ivy League. Bald-Headed Woman is a traditional blues song covered by the British rock band The Kinks on their stellar debut album in 1964. And by the way, John Lord played the organ piano on that one. Is that amazing? So Jimmy Page, he played lead guitar in the Who's version of that song. And he says it wasn't really lead, he later clarifies. It was just a couple of phrases. So according to John Entwistle, Jimmy Page played on the recording because he owned the only fuzz box in UK. Is that hilarious? So the fuzz guitar droning throughout is played by Jimmy Page. But the time when Pete Townshend got really upset was when Jimmy Page tried to steal his bandmates. Actually, a year later, after that session with The Who, Jimmy Page invited Who members, drummer Keith Moon and bassist John Entwistle, I mean, get this, to form a super group with his buddy Jeff Beck. They secretly got together in the studio and recorded an instrumental, Beck's Bolero, which was written by Jimmy Page. So when The Who singer Roger Daltrey began missing gigs in England, which caused Pete Townshend and John Entwistle to share vocals, a certain 17-year-old rocker noticed the band needed a lead singer and boldly offered his services. This is great, and Pete later recalls. Robert Plant came to see us three nights in a row and offered himself for the job, as did Steve Gibbons. And when he came to see us, Roger wasn't there. So obviously, none of them thought I was any good. It was during the stage of The Who's disintegration that Beck's Bolero was recorded. So Pete got really angry. When he learned that Jeff Beck and Jimmy Page had covertly approached his bandmates to do a record, Pete trashed the pair as flashy little guitarists of very little brain, to which Jimmy Page fires back, Townshend got into feedback because he couldn't play single notes. So Jeff Beck recalls, I remember Pete Townshend, you know, looking at me with daggers, giving me that evil eye at me when he heard it, because it was, you know, a bit near the mark. He didn't want anybody meddling with his territory, his band, The Who, and all that. In a later interview, Townshend explains, the thing is, when Keith did Beck's Bolero, that wasn't just a session, that was a political move. It was at a point when the group was very close to breaking up. Keith was very paranoid. He was going through that heavy pills thing. He wanted to make the group plead for him because he joined Beck. So differences with Moon resolved and he returned to The Who shortly after the recording. 1 month later, Page joined the Yardbirds and together with Beck became one of the first dual lead guitar teams in popular rock. I mean, could you imagine seeing one of the shows? It'd be amazing. John Entwistle was scheduled to play bass, but he left just at the very last minute. So John Paul Jones was called in as a replacement. Can you imagine that? So Beck, Page, Hopkins, Jones, and Moon planned to record a whole album, but contractual obligations prevented them from recording together, and this was the only song that came from those sessions that were released eventually as a B-side. I mean, wow, what amazing stuff. Keith Moon couldn't leave The Who, and he resorted to arriving at the studio during the sessions in disguise so no one would know he was playing with another band. Oh, this is hilarious stuff. So, Pete was obviously bitter that his his best members were leaving him with no band to form a band with Jimmy Page behind his back. So after Beck's Bolero, Jimmy Page joined his buddy Jeff Beck in the Yardbirds, and a bit later, the Yardbirds transformed into Led Zeppelin, which became the biggest selling band of the 70s. So Pete had a certain amount of jealousy because The Who came way before Zeppelin, and Keith Moon actually gave them their name. It was at the Bolero session that the assembled musicians talked of forming a permanent supergroup, to which Page said Keith Moon scoffed, that would go over like a Led Zeppelin. Peter Grant, though, Led Zeppelin's manager, disagreed and claimed that Moon said the band would go down like a lead balloon. Peter Grant's pretty protective over Led Zeppelin, so he would, you know, I can understand he would say that even if he lied. And that it was actually Entwistle who coined the name. Pete Townshend grew to despise by adding more like a Led Zeppelin. However, when forming the band, they took the A out of lead, and not to confuse people. So, while The Who have sold somewhere in the neighborhood of 100 million records over the decades, they didn't have the immediate and overwhelming success Led Zeppelin enjoyed. In the high range, some estimate Led Zeppelin album sales at 300 million units. Led Zeppelin also set box office records for concerts in the 70s. Compared to almost anyone, they were so huge that it was impossible to compete with. In 1972, Led Zeppelin made more money than the Elvis and Beatles combined together and toured in a commercial jet plane with Led Zeppelin painted on the side. For Pete Townshend, The Who paved the way for bands like Led Zeppelin. So Pete was bitter and jealous that Jimmy Page and his band Led Zeppelin came in and made it so big, so fast. Actually, The Who singer Roger Daltrey and Jimmy Page worked together on a B-side for Daltrey's first solo album in 1973. Daltrey says that he would love to form a blues band with the Led Zeppelin guitarist. Who wouldn't? I'd love to do an album with Jimmy. He needs a singer to drive him. I don't sing the blues with The Who, but that's what I used to be before Townshend started writing, Daltrey says. I used to be a great blues singer.